My question is to the Prime Minister. I refer to the Prime Minister's answer in the House on Monday as to whether she'd written to the WA Commissioner for Corporate Affairs to vouch for the bona fides of the AWU Workplace Reform Association, quote, the association is only incorporated if the authority is satisfied, quote, clearly the registrar must have been so satisfied or they would not have incorporated the association. Given the Prime Minister's statement this week, she provided legal advice to establish the association and her failure to rule out writing to the Commissioner on Monday, I asked the Prime Minister again, did she at any time write to the Commissioner about...
The Prime Minister has the call.
Thank you very much, Speaker, and as the matter grows more and more embarrassing from the point of view of the Deputy Leader of the Opposition, I remind her that in this House and outside this House I've consistently answered questions about this matter and how I provided advice as a lawyer on the association, and no amount of sneer changes that simple fact. In relation to sneer and the line of opposition questioning today, the Deputy Leader of the Opposition's questions have been based on Michael Smith's blog today. That is her only source, is Michael Smith.
Prime Minister, we'll presume to seek the member from McKellar on a point of order.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I refer you to page 565 of these factors and also page 516. Clearly the Prime Minister is given the right to absolutely refuse to answer questions, which he does repeatedly in this chamber. But she also, on page 516, chooses to use abusive and insulting language the nature of life is likely to create disorder. Clearly she does, Madam Speaker, and the point of order is this, that if she is not prepared to answer the questions, she should at least take them on notice, or say she is not prepared to answer them, when in this chamber, it is time she says
the member for McKellar will resume her seat. The member for Mass might be telling people a great many things, but not in the chamber in the next couple of minutes if he's not careful. The Prime Minister has the call and will return to the question before the Chair. The Prime Minister has the call.
Thank you very much, Speaker, and to the member for McKellar's point of order and to the question in general, I have answered questions about my role as a solicitor relating to providing legal advice on this association. I am also pointing out to the House that the Opposition's tactics today have been dictated by Michael Smith's blog. Who is Michael Smith? Well, he is the man who was sacked for wanting to defame me, basing that defamation on an affidavit drawn up by John Pascarelli of One Nation fame. Who is Michael Smith?
I will point out to the Manager of Opposition Business that the one point of order on this question has been taken. So the Manager of Opposition Business on a different point of order, the Manager of Opposition Business, I will listen carefully, but be warned.
You directed the Prime Minister to be relevant to the questions that she's being asked. And how could talking about Michael Smith be in the least bit relevant? So she's defying your ruling.
The Manager of Opposition Business
your ruling
will resume his seat. With all these questions, there is a great deal of information given before the question is put. The Prime Minister has the call and will go to the question before the Chair.
Thank you. I'm dealing with this in the sense that the source of these allegations is Michael Smith. Who is Michael Smith? He's the man accompanying Ralph Blewett around Australia. Who is Michael Smith? He's the man who rang the Deputy Leader of the Opposition and handed the phone over so she could speak to Ralph Blewett. What is the Deputy Leader of the Opposition's version of these events? That Michael Smith rang her up and she had no idea who the phone was going to be handed over to. Who was she expecting? Humphrey B. Bear? Oh no, he can't drive.
Prime Minister, will you return to the question?
Who on earth was she expecting on the phone? And why didn't she tell the truth about it yesterday?
The Deputy Leader of the Opposition on a supplementary.
My question to the Prime Minister. I refer to her answers in this House. Did the Prime Minister write to the WA Commissioner for Corporate Affairs to vouch for the bona fides of the AWU Workplace Reform Association, yes or no?
The Prime
Minister has the call. Thank you very much, Speaker. And given the Leader of the Opposition read along to every word of that question from the Deputy Leader, get up and ask it yourself and then I'll answer it.